Celebrating our connection with our pets. This is Animal Radio. Here are your hosts, Hal Abrams and Judy Francis.
And your dream team, Dr. Debbie answering your vet medical questions, dog trainer Alan Cable, the dog father Joey Volani, animal communicator Joy Turner, and we welcome to the team this weekend, Miss Wendy Diamond.
Welcome, Wendy. How are you doing?
I am fabulous. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
We'll talk a little more about where you come from and all of that stuff in just a couple of minutes. We are live this week from Las Vegas and the Mandalay Convention Center for SuperZoo. This is our new pet product special that we do every year. And what we do is we visit with all the people that are bringing out the new pet products. They do a trade show here in Las Vegas where they show off all the things that you'll be seeing in your stores coming up within the next few weeks. And we have giveaways. Everything that we're talking about today, we'll have giveaways. So write down this number, 1-866-405-8405. And I see, Joey, you're sampling all the giveaways.
Yeah. I hate giveaways. You know why I hate giveaways? Because we're not allowed to get anything.
Well, wait a minute.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
We need to do product reviews. I always go around the floor with Ladybug and get as much stuff as I can, Joey. I bring my dog with me.
I like want everything. Don't forget, hey, this is my birthday week, guys. So,
this is your birthday week.
All the giveaways should come to me, and yeah, I think that's only fair.
Well, we buy you dinner for your birthday.
Wendy's, you know, Wendy's new with us, so definitely Wendy can have, a portion of mine, a little bit.
Thank you. I did invite you to Chippendales.
You want to go to Chippendales for your birthday?
Listen. Wendy's a good-looking lady. I'll go anywhere with her right now.
Don't forget, my baby Hope is the cutest thing on earth.
Wait a second.
Oh, I know. We all think that about our dogs. I know. Okay, I'm going to take that back because I'm new in town.
Yeah, I have my little Ladybug with me.
Ladybug.
She's the cutest.
Stacy, what are you working on, girlfriend?
You know, I was in Costco the other day, and I was loading up this big 50-pound bag of dog food into my cart. I have three dogs, so 50 pounds lasts me a couple weeks.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, this guy goes, oh, that's crappy dog food. I wouldn't feed that to my dogs. I go, shut the heck up. I mean, my dogs eat this, and they're happy, and it's not a big deal. So the question is it worth it to buy premium dog food? Is that really better for your dog?
Hell yeah.
It's the age-old question when you're a dog owner. I'll tell you the answer. Are coming up on Animal Radio News.
That's all on the way.
Aren't most of our sponsors like premium dog
they
food?
They are
people,
premium.
So yes. Let's do the right thing.
We can answer that right now.
We don't feed our pets junk.
No, we don't.
That's right.
And that's, I'll tell you right now, and Dr. Debbie's looking at us. She's furious now. Anybody that calls in and says, I'm feeding my dog Old Roy, she will hang up on you immediately. That's what's happening there. What are you all going to be talking about, Joey, today? What do you got on the agenda?
I got a good email today from a guy from Florida that has a Siberian Husky mix, which I don't know what he's doing with Siberian Husky mix in the heat of Florida, but he's having a problem with the heat and the grooming and what the hell to do you. So we're going to teach him a lesson.
Okay, stick around for that. We're live from Las Vegas this week, 1-866-405-8405. Still answering your questions. Judy, the phone lines are burning white hot, are they not?
They are. They won't stop ringing.
Okay, so we'll be going to the phones next right here on Animal Radio. Stick around.
It's Vinny Penn coming back at you. I got six words for you to kick off this week's Party Animal installment. A snake is not a pet. Now, I'm not talking about the dorm room snake where everybody sits around doing bong tokes and gathers in Chucko's room to watch him feed a mouse to the snake. I'm talking about when you're at an outdoor festival, a flea market or whatnot, as I was with my family the other, and you lean over and you see this guy's got this huge thing on his shoulders, and it's rather still. You think it's kind of a funky new kind of, if he wasn't wearing his Harley t-shirt, you'd think it was the hottest, latest trend in scarves. And then it moves and you realize, oh, it's a massive white snake on his shoulders. I mean, this guy had friggin' anaconda on his at a flea market. When the forked tongue started flicking out, my daughter shrieked like Jason Voorhees had just shown up. I took her to see Friday the 13th. Not a good move. She's very young for that. But I must reiterate, a snake is not a pet. Or at the very least, You don't take your snake for a walk. And that's not a metaphor. Vinny Penn, Party Animal, Animal Radio.
Celebrating our connection with our pets. This is Animal Radio. Here are your hosts, Al Abrams and Judy Francis.
And your dream team. Dr. Debbie answering your vet medical questions. Dog trainer Alan Cable. Dog father Joey Villani. Animal communicator Joey Turner. And brand new to the team, the very charismatic Wendy Diamond joins us.
Wendy did that so good, by the way, Hal.
I want to go. You know what's so funny about, okay, because like I don't mean to do it. I just do that.
How can you not?
Oh, there you go.
Well, you know.
This should be a tornado warning.
Oh.
I'm just kidding.
Oh, you know, I don't care.
Welcome to the team, Wendy. 1-866-405-8405. We're coming to you live this weekend from Las Vegas in the Mandalay Convention Center for SuperZoo. This is the convention where all the animal people get together and we look at all the brand new products that are coming out for the new year before they're in the stores. And we'll head down to the floor in just a couple of minutes and tell you all about all these products. In fact, we'll have giveaways of all these products. So make sure you have that number, 1-866-405-8405. Stacey, what's going on?
Well, Rihanna is the latest star to be targeted by PETA. You'll never guess why. She was wearing a pair of boots that PETA didn't think were made for walking. I'll tell you about it coming up on Animal Radio News.
Oh, as you know, I'm always behind PETA, whatever they say. I live my life by PETA.
What?
Let's hit the phones. 1-866-405-8405. Let's head to line four. Is that correct, Judy?
Yes, and let's take that caller.
Deborah on for Alan. Hey, Deborah, thanks for waiting on hold there.
Yes, you're welcome. I have a question about my Boston Terrier.
What's going on?
Go ahead, Deb.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm listening, Deb. Dr. Fraser Crane here. I'm listening.
Okay. All right. I drive a truck long distance, and while we're out on the road, he does great. But when we go home for time off, he decides to urinate in the house. I don't know what to do about it.
Deb, here's the thing. Your dog might be a little confused. Do you have a routine when you get home? Do you have a routine for taking your dog out? Do you take him out certain times during the day?
Yes, he has the backyard fenced in, so, you know, he goes out constantly.
But do you take them out personally?
Oh, I don't.
All right, sweetie. Here's what you need to do. Dogs pee in the house for just a couple of different reasons. It seems complicated, but a lot of times it's either separation anxiety, they're marking their territory, they can't hold it, they get excited, or they're being submissive. And the best way to eliminate that is to put your dog on a schedule and take him out at distinct times during the day. So you would basically, after he eats, take him out. First thing in the morning, take him out. Before he goes to bed, take him out. And a couple of times scattered during the day. Don't wait for the dog to tell you he needs to go out. Take him out on a leash. And as soon as he starts going outside, tell him what a good dog he is. Have you been reprimanding him or punishing him when he goes in the house?
Yes, he's putting time out.
Yeah, don't punish him when he goes in the house, because a lot of times they don't know why they're being punished. They don't make the connection. Sometimes when you punish a dog in the house for going to the bathroom, they think you're punishing them because they're going to the bathroom in front of you, you know? So it's kind of like you got to take him outside and spend more time praising him and rewarding him, much less time punishing him. It works way better when you praise and you reward a dog than when you punish a dog, because it confuses them. They don't know why they're being punished much of the time. Does that make sense to you?
Yes, it does.
All right, girl, you try that out and keep on trucking. Hey, before you go, what are you hauling?
I got on medical supplies today.
Oh, that's beautiful. How much can I have?
You have to find me first.
Thank you.
Well, good luck to you, girl.
You have a good day, thanks.
Thanks for your call, Deborah. 1-866-405-8405. Having more fun than legally allowed by law, I believe. It is Animal Radio live from Las Vegas. John. Hey, John, how are you doing today?
Hey, I'm good. Thanks for taking the call.
What's going on?
Just a quick question. I have a 10-year-old dog. She's got a little growth a couple of weeks back that looks like a little sty or a wart or something on her lower eyelid, but it doesn't interfere with her blinking or anything like that. I'm just wondering if that's something I need to check out.
Yeah. Now, what kind of doggy? I'm sorry?
She's a mutt from the pound and likes heifers, and I got her off the res, and I'm told she's cowdy mix.
Okay. And is the lump, is it on the inside of the eye, on the outside? What area? Coming in
it's
from the nose
outside.
To the side. On the outside. Okay. Well,
lower eyelid.
the good majority of little masses along a dog's eyelid, they tend to be benign growths. And of those, they most commonly are a type called a meibomian gland tumor. So that's by far the biggest cause of these type of things. So those type of things, not to say they can't cause a problem, and sometimes they can actually get pretty big. They'll kind of even get a cauliflower-like growth off of them, and they can rub on the eye. So some of these really can cause ulcers in the eye or discomfort. So the treatment of those, first I'd say, you know, get a look at it. If you'd hold up the mic, I can, you know, try to get a picture of things. You know, getting a vet's eye on it is a big thing, because sometimes there are types of lumps and bumps that get us a little bit more excited. If they're pigmented, kind of a black color, sometimes that gets us a little bit more concerned, because we can get melanoma, a more serious tumor that occurs on the eyelid. And then some types can be a little bit more destructive to the area, like squamous cell carcinoma. You know, people are aware of that because of the sun-related issues. So that for dogs too can occur on the eyelids. So
would they zap it off and test
sometimes.
It, or what would they?
Yeah, so when we have an eyelid tumor, pretty much we have to remove those type of things with a pet under anesthesia. And I get that question all the time. Can you do it with my pet awake? No, not going to happen. Not many dogs okay. will sit for that. So from there, but yes, we can do a couple of things. We can, if it's large and it goes into the lid, we might do kind of like a V-shaped wedge. So we take out a little wedge of the eyelid and sew things back up. If it's small and doesn't seem to go very deep, then yes, we can kind of cauterize that either with an electrocautery. At my office, we have a laser that we use, and that helps to kind of ablate the tissue or just kind of destroy it on the surface. So that technique can be used for some of the smaller or less serious ones. If we're worried that it's a more serious tumor, we're going to probably go for that V wedge, because we want to get nice, clean margins and solve that problem for, you know, the long haul. But,
Tell by looking at it? If I brought her into the office, can you look at it and say, yeah, it looks like this or it looks like that?
In some cases, yeah. But I would say just because the great majority of these type of tumors are meibomian gland tumors. And, you know, the breed sometimes gives us some clues, because we know that there are some dogs like poodles, cocker spaniels, collies that tend to get these benign eyelid tumors a little bit more frequently. So if we've got that, there's sometimes a little bit of the odds game we can play to help. And that may not help your situation, since you have a mixed breed dog. Potentially.
Yeah, I was wondering whether or not to make an appointment, so it sounds like I should.
Yeah, absolutely. I would definitely encourage you. And, you know, it could be something we can handle pretty simply. And just sometimes a little bit of, you know, monitoring, watching, and waiting is acceptable for these type of things.
Beautiful. I will keep an eye on it, but I'll make an appointment for next week as well. Thanks for the information. I sure appreciate it.
Thanks for the call, John. 1-866-405-8405. This portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by Pets Day. The dog days are every day with Pets Day, available exclusively from Imperial Palace and Rio Resorts in Las Vegas. Pets Day provides the unique in-room amenities like food, water, sleeping mat, dog treats, and even a specialty room service menu. Details at caesars.com/petstaylasvegas. And tonight in Las Vegas, where we are, by the way, Rod Stewart.
Woohoo! Let's go see
Woo!
Him. I know! Let's go!
That's awesome, man.
Look at that little Judy's getting all blushing.
You know, it always brings back my dream that...
You dreamt about Rod Stewart?
Well, we were married.
You were married to him?
Yes, I was.
Yeah, that's a dream.
Oh, my goodness.
I know.
What number were you? Number wife were you?
I think I was on the out, though, because I think he had my replacement already.
Already?
Yeah.
In your dream, too.
I know.
Wow. Okay, well, you can check him out tonight. He's playing at the Coliseum at Caesar's Palace. I'm sure the bouncers will keep you away from him. $49 to get in the door, or $250 to sit up in spittle distance. That's where you get Rod Stewart's spittle all over.
Where's my credit card?
Concierge desk, this is Amanda. Yes, I can recommend a great place for a walk.
Imperial Palace and Rio in Las Vegas are rolling out four-star treatment for our four-legged friends. Our new pet stay program includes in-room accommodations for up to two dogs, food and water dishes, sleeping mat, dog treats, specialty room service menus, and more. The dog days are here. Book your stay at caesars.com/petstaylasvegas or call 800-427-7247.
Help prevent pests on your pet with monthly topical flea or tick treatments. Advantage 2 for cats or dogs kills through contact, so fleas don't have to bite to die. Canine Advantix 2, which is for dogs only, repels and kills ticks, fleas, and mosquitoes, repels biting flies, and kills lice. Advantage 2 and Canine Advantix 2 kill all flea life stages, including eggs and larvae. Advantage 2 and Canine Advantix 2 are recommended by veterinarians and are available at animal hospitals and pet specialty retailers.
What dog food is specifically designed to reduce the risk of cancer, settle digestive upsets, reduce scratching and shedding? Canine Caviar. What dog food reduces red tear stains and hot spots? Canine Caviar. What dog food has probiotics that reduce the chance of soft stools and have a higher calorie count for better nutrient absorption? Canine Caviar. So what are you feeding your dog? If you didn't answer Canine Caviar, visit caninecaviar.com today and get your pet started on a longer, healthier life.
Some nights I can't get to sleep. Some nights I can't stay asleep. With Unisom, I can do both.
Unisom sleep tabs are clinically proven to help you fall asleep 33% faster and keep you asleep longer, so you get a more restful night's sleep. Made with an ingredient not found in other leading sleep aids, Unisom sleep tabs are safe and non-habit forming. Just one pill takes the uncertainty out of bedtime, giving you the sleep you need.
So I wake up ready to go.
Unisom sleep tabs. Fall asleep faster. Sleep longer.
You're listening to Animal Radio. You can learn more at animalradio.com. Log on. Learn more.
Hey, this is Sean Hayes on Animal Radio. Remember to spay and neuter your pets.
After, they want to make their dogs look more manly by giving them bigger you-know-whats.
You know what? I've had definitely the nudicles that we had put in, but it wasn't really a Vegas-y thing. We've got some interesting clientele, but they really are very respectful for their pets, and I haven't really had any weird cosmetic surgery requests.
If you just tuned in, we are live from Las Vegas, and during the break right there, Alan asked Dr. Debbie if any crazy people come in there in Vegas and ask for cosmetic surgery for their dogs, to make their parts look bigger or something along those lines. I assume that's what you were asking.
I want my dog to look like Dolly Parton and Bruce Jenner mixed together.
We are live from Las Vegas and the Mandalay Convention Center for SuperZoo. We're checking out all the new pet products that are available, and well, actually, that will be available in your pet stores very soon. A lot of great ideas. There's over 700 vendors here, 700 people, a lot of mom and pops, people that, I guess, in the recession, lost their day job as an accountant and had a great idea for a pet product, and they're bringing it to town now. And we're checking them out. We have giveaways of everything that we're talking about today. So 1-866-405-8405 is the number that you need to get in touch with us when we give these away. And in fact, let's kick off this segment with a giveaway from Frolly Cat, the Frolly Cat bundle. This is a bundle of toys for your kitty. Got to have a kitty for this. It includes the Frolly Cat Bolt, which is an interactive laser toy. It will provide hours of fun for you and your feline friends. All you have to do is hold it in your hand or place it on a flat surface and watch your cat pounce, chase, and bat at all the exciting laser patterns. The bundle also includes the Frolly Cat Twitch, which is, I thought I had the Frolly Cat Twitch for a long time, but then I realized it's a toy. And what I have is just...
Your doctor corrected you.
The Frolly Cat Twitch automatically bounces and swings an enticing teaser toy. You just press the power button and launch a single play session, or press and hold and activate multiple sessions throughout the day. Your cat can play while you are away. Also in the bundle, the Frolly Cat Dart, which is an automatic rotating laser light that provides hours of fun for you and your feline and canine friends.
Not just your cat. I know, you said you had to have a feline. I was going to correct you there. It's for dogs, too.
It works for the dogs,
too. They enjoy it, yes.
Place the dart on the floor, turn it on, and watch the chase begin. Variable speeds and timer settings offer 16 exciting play combinations. This is all part of the Frolly Cat bundle. You can learn more about it at frollycat.com. That's F-R-O-L-I. CAT.com. Let's give one away right now. 1-866-405-8405. The whole dream team is here. Dr. Debbie answering your vet medical questions. Alan Cable, our dog trainer extraordinaire. Dog father Joey Volani. Animal communicator Joy Turner. And we add to the team this weekend Wendy Diamond. Ah! Where is she? She gone? She's gone already?
What adjective are you going to describe her with this break?
I have no idea. She's a real spitball. And I just want to make sure she's not around anywhere before I come up with any kind of adjectives.
Well, you just
I think it's
spitfire.
A spitfire. She's not spitfire? A spitball.
Okay. Spitfire is what I meant to say.
She was attractive. She was charismatic. She was bubbly. What's she going to be now?
Spitfire.
Hey, can I just say, you know, all this time I thought this glare in my eyes was the bright lights of Vegas, and it turned out to be Joey's teeth. Unbelievable.
Isn't that amazing?
I thought you were going to say it was turned out to be Wendy Diamond.
Hey, Teresa, how are you doing?
Good. How about you?
Good. Where are you calling from today?
I'm calling from Pasadena, California.
Lovely L.A. area. So what's going on in your world?
Okay, I have two dogs. One is 10, one is 4. Both of them are rescue dogs. So I got the 4-year-old 2 years ago when he was 2. So potty train is almost like impossible for me. I know as I put him into the cage or so, but that way he's going to bark like hell. So I live in a condo. That's almost impossible. My neighbor's going to like kill me.
Oh.
Because he bark if I put him into the crate or something. I think the way I see it, he's kind of insecure. He pee basically every corner he can find. Now he's a little bit better, but I realized that it was just like he cannot be home alone. And he's following me and following whatever everything my 10-year-old dog's doing. They are both poodle mix. And the only thing he doesn't copy from the older dog is like older dog can pee like just on a piece of paper. I put it in the garage. So that's impossible. If I take the older dog with me to go outside doing something, no way. Otherwise, the younger one would make a mess at home. Like, he pee everywhere, even more. If his home
you got a big problem there, girl. You sound like you're upset and nervous and anxious about it yourself, are you?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, the first thing you got to do is, and I know Debbie will concur with this, you always got to make sure when a dog starts going in the house or does go in the house that there's no medical problem. Just to be on the safe side, always have a vet look into it because there's a lot of medical reasons why a dog will pee inside the house. And the second thing you have to do is take a deep breath. You got to calm yourself down. You got to relax and you got to tell yourself, I'm the boss. I'm in charge. I am the leader. Those dogs are looking to you for leadership. Now, the dog that's peeing in the house is already decided that the leader of the pack is the other dog, not you. And that's a problem. You've got to be the leader of the pack. You have to be the calm, in charge controller, the leader. You've got to be in charge of when they go out. You've got to be in charge of praising them when they do the right thing and correcting them when they do something that you don't want. But correcting, that's a really important thing for you to think about. Rubbing the dog's nose in it, yelling, smacking with a newspaper, slapping, that only confuses your dog and makes your dog more nervous. What you've got to do is keep a leash on the dog that's going in the house, and as soon as your dog makes a move to go, you say no, and you take the dog outside and start saying, bathroom, go to the bathroom. Bathroom, go to the bathroom. And when the dog does, you praise the dog. The other thing you have to have is a regular schedule. You have to let your dog go outside regular times, you know, after a nap, after they eat, before they go to bed when they first wake up. And you do have to keep the dog in a crate if you can't watch the dog, or even in the garage. You say your dog barks, use the garage as a crate. That way, if the dog goes to the bathroom, no big deal in the garage to clean it up. But the more time you spend with your dog, the more time you're there with your dog to actually control the situation and show the dog the right behavior calmly, the better success you're going to have. You've got to have a regular schedule. That's the most important thing, structure.
Okay. But
can you do that?
He's just like behaving like so insecure, you know. So it's just like,
well, he's insecure. He's insecure because he's not sure who's in charge. When you put a dog in the position of having to be in charge and there's no clear pack leader, it makes them anxious and nervous. And sometimes they get separation anxiety, too, when you leave. You know, you've got to be calm and in charge. The calmer you are, the more in charge you are, the more mellow the dog is going to get over time. The problem will disappear. You've got to calm yourself down.
How about like barking? Like an older dog loves to bark. Whenever he hear any noises outdoor, outside, you know.
Well, where is the dog when the dog starts barking? Anywhere in the house or by the window, by the door? Where is your dog when the dog starts barking?
Anywhere. If it's anywhere. Not by the window, I try to close all the window because that way it's more quiet.
What do you do when your dog starts barking? What do you do?
I try to remove him from that particular position or where.
What do you do though? What do you do? Do you speak loudly? Do you pull on the leash? Do you yell? Do you scream? Do you start talking to the dog? What do you do?
I usually start calling his name.
All right. You
and
know what?
I try to grab his attention from somewhere else. I say, "Oh, here you go." You know,
all right, listen. As soon as you put a leash on your dog, get one of those little handles, and always let it be on your dog. Never take it off. As soon as the dog starts to bark, you grab that leash and you give it a little flick and go, no! Just like that. As soon as the dog stops barking for a little bit of time, 30, 40, 50 seconds, you say, good dog, and give the dog a treat. Every time your dog does what you want it to do, you praise the dog and give the dog affection. Every time the dog does what you don't want it to do, you correct or ignore.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, go to work, girl. Girl, you got some work to do, man. You have got some work to do. And you know what? I encourage you to go on the internet or go to the bookstore and read about dog communication and dog behavior. Educate yourself. That's your most powerful tool because I don't live with you. And if I did, I'd be barking out the window. But I don't. So you've got to go to the store and go on the internet and educate yourself.
Okay. All right.
Good luck. Yeah,
good job. You're a good lady. You're a good dog owner. You care.
Thanks for your call today, Teresa. 1-866-405-8405. This portion of Animal Radio brought to you by Litter Robot, which automatically cleans the cat litter for you. It reduces odor, and customers report it cuts their litter usage by half. Imagine that. You don't need any special supplies or plumbing, just your favorite clumpy litter, and never scoop dirty litter again. They know you love it so much, they offer you a 90-day money-back guarantee. It's available at litter-robot.com. Animal Radio customers get a $15 discount with code ANIMALRADIO, all in lowercase, when you check out at litter-robot.com.
There's no doubt that it's a great time to be alive. Our grandparents could only imagine smartphones, GPS tracking, robotic vacuums, and the litter robot. Yes, I said the litter robot. Technology that automatically cleans the litter box for you. No more nasty litter boxes to stink up the house, and always a clean, safe place for your kitties to do their business. It's so efficient and earth-friendly that you'll use half the litter, saving both time and money. And the litter robot doesn't need any special waste receptacles, chemicals, or plumbing. Just use your favorite clumping litter. This is how it works. 7 minutes after your cat uses the litter robot, the patented litter sifting system automatically empties the waste directly into a bag-lined waste drawer, leaving a clean bed of litter for the next use. We know you'll love it so much, we offer a 90-day guarantee. You're on the cutting edge of technology, so why are you still cleaning the litter box the old-fashioned way? Step up to the self-cleaning litter robot, available online at litterrobot.com. That's litter-robot.com.
This is Judy from Animal Radio. For months now, I've been telling you about the Stella and Chewy's dog food. Now I want to tell you about their cat food, made with 100% raw meat. And just like all Stella and Chewy's products, these dinners are made without grains, fillers, artificial preservatives, colorings, sugar, or salt. They come in four flavors: Chick Chick Chicken, Super Beefalicious, Charming Chicken and Beef, and Yummy Lickin' Salmon and Chicken. Visit their website at StellaAndChewy's.com. That's Chewy's, C-H-E-W-Y-S.
Hey, honey.
Hi, Dad.
What you drawing?
It's our house. That's you.
Oh.
Me.
Huh?
Mom and Josh.
Wow.
Playing ball.
You are becoming quite the artist.
When you're a kid, you don't know that home ownership builds communities, that owning a home contributes to higher self-esteem and better test scores. You just know that home is where you play, grow, and learn. The National Association of Realtors wants you to know that home ownership matters to our families, our neighborhoods, and our country. Learn more at houselogic.com/homeownership.
This is an Animal Radio News update brought to you by the Scoop-Free Self-Cleaning Litter Box. Never see, touch, or smell messy waste again.
I'm Stacy Cohen for Animal Radio. Their job often requires them to rescue plenty of cats, even the occasional bear, but firefighters in England were shocked by a recent call. It asked them to help rescue a cow that was stuck in a tree. The Daily Telegraph reports Sparkle, who's a 660-pound calf, had fallen more than 100 feet down an embankment and landed in the tree. A spokesperson for the Cumbra Fire Rescue Service says it took three fire crews 4 hours to rescue Sparkle, but their hard work did pay off. Sparkle's owner, Philip Armstrong, said the animal appeared to be in a state of shock, but the vet checked her out and she was fine. Rihanna is the latest pop star to spark the ire of PETA for her wardrobe. Britain's Daily Express says the animal rights organization is calling the singer out for her thigh-high snakeskin boots she was seen wearing in London. PETA reps recall Rihanna's tearful discussion about her relationship with Chris Brown and saying that the snakes are brutally killed for fashion, but they can't go on Oprah to cry about it. Nobody can because her show's canceled. But PETA calls wearing snakeskin creepy and callous and says that in wearing the reptile skin, she looks even more out of touch. The organization added that Rihanna seems to be so desperate to be a freak instead of recognized for her talents that it's unclear if she even realizes that she's being laughed at. You know, I don't know. Snakes shed their skin naturally anyway. Can't you just take some of that skin that's shed and then glue it on some boots? I think that would be fine. And who wants to wear, you know, thigh-high boots anyway? That's so uncomfortable and hot, especially in the summer. Okay, I'm the fashionista. Add one more problem caused by drought this summer. This is a bad problem, too. It's a shortage of cow pies. To the east of Minnesota, organizers had changed their lineup for the annual Wisconsin cow chip throwing contest. The quality of this year's crop, as it were, pretty questionable. About 200 cow pies were being held in reserve. Well, they were used to supplement the few that are okay to throw. The chips are the size of table tennis paddles, and workers normally shovel the manure in July. Then they let it dry and just flatten in the sun. But that operation scrapped this year because of the poor quality of the manure as a result of the drought. See, drought affects a lot of things. The record cow pie throw, it stands at 248 feet. You might want to get out and practice, maybe with a Frisbee or something. Or use that stuff in the front yard from your dog. That'll work. I'm Stacy Cohen. Get more animal breaking news at animalradio.com.
This has been an Animal Radio News Update brought to you by the Scoop Free Self-Cleaning Litter Box. Just replace a disposable litter tray once every few weeks and never handle messy waste again. Learn more at scoopfree.com.
Do you enjoy cleaning your cat's litter box? I didn't think so. Scoop Free is the litter box that cleans itself, so you don't have to. Scoop Free automatically rakes waste away, but unlike other systems, you can leave Scoop Free alone for weeks at a time without handling waste or refilling litter. All you do is replace a disposable litter tray, and you'll never see, smell, or touch messy waste again. Learn more about the number one rated automatic litter box at scoopfree.com.
When you're in the mood for the perfect cup of coffee or tea, look to the Bosch Tassimo Home Brewing System with unique barcode technology. Enjoy your home brew in the peace of your kitchen, virtually silent thanks to Bosch dishwashers. Bosch has the quietest dishwasher line in North America, which is one of the many reasons that Bosch dishwashers are ranked number one and a best value by a leading consumer publication. And because it's a Bosch, you'll know you're getting the best. We've built versatility into everything we design. It's time to step up to Bosch. Visit a Best Buy store near you or go to bestbuy.com/Bosch for special offers and product information. Bosch, invented for life. Bosch offers the quietest dishwashers in North America, and no major brand offers a quieter model at any Bosch price point. June 2012. Class defined by similarly priced and designed models of major brands based on a leading consumer publication, June 2012. Tassimo is a registered trademark of Kraft Foods.
Vetrisin, a one-stop wound and skin care product that will not harm healthy tissue. Vetrisin is great for hot spots, cuts, scratches, and even rashes. Vetrisin is non-toxic and is safe for puppies and kittens. This safe, easy-to-apply product makes caring for your pet's wounds or irritations easy. Be sure to have some on hand at all times. Great for the dog park and traveling. Visit Vetrisin's Facebook page to see how you can win free product. For more information, go to vetrisin.com. That's vetrisin.com.
The It's Animal Radio, and we are live from SuperZoo at the Mandalay Bay Convention Center. We're finally out on the floor. This is my favorite part.
I'd love to go ahead and get out and see what's new and go shopping for my babies.
And there's over 871 vendors this year. So it's, I think there was 700 last year, 500 the year before. It is a $53 billion a year industry that we're in.
Absolutely. Everyone loves our pets, and we want to take good care of them. So that's what it's all about.
I noticed that you're all color coordinated today. Your green eyes match your green outfit.
You know, we had a lot of rain here in Las Vegas, so I wanted
What is that about?
You know, it's the monsoon. It doesn't rain too often out here, but when it does, man, it comes down hard.
Yesterday, the first time since 1999, it rained as much on the Strip.
Yeah, and a lot of visitors here at the booths noticed that cars were being kind of washed away. People were rescued from their cars out in flooded areas.
Wow, but that hasn't changed the turnout here at SuperZoo. Now, remember, the best thing about the SuperZoo show is that we are giving away one of everything we're talking about, all the brand new pet products that we're featuring today on Animal Radio. With me from Petmate, our good friends at Petmate, is Christina Quezada. Is that how you say it?
Yes, Quezada.
Oh, Quezada. Okay, I'm well known for slaughtering names left and right. What do you got new this year?
Well, we have a lot of new stuff at SuperZoo. All of our new 2012 products are at the booth. But what I have here for you guys is our Portion Right food dispenser. It is the newest launch in our feeding line.
Well, now, portion dispensers are nothing new. You got some. This is kind of special. This is different than other food dispensers. Why is that?
Correct. We have gravity feeders, as you may be familiar with, that dispense food throughout the day whenever a pet needs to eat. And then you have the electronic food dispensers, which you can program. We have kind of married the two ideas and introduced this solution for pet owners who love the convenience and price point of a gravity feeder, but are concerned about making sure that their pets get healthy portions, which is very important. And this is what this feeder does for pet owners.
Yeah, most feeders, I guess, free feed them, and that can lead to obese animals, huh?
Oh, that's one thing veterinarians have a problem with, is the open bowl philosophy where we can overdo it. So this is ingenious that we can watch that waistline, but still make it convenient for the pet owner.
And Dr. Debbie's always getting on our case for free feeding our dog with one of these feeders. So I'm going to get one of these new feeders. It's the Portion Right food dispenser from Petmate. We're going to give one away?
Yes. We're going to give one away to a lucky listener, and then they can, you know, test it out for themselves and see all the great features. One of the great features, actually, that is very unique to this type of dispenser is a rotating knob that actually clicks and lets a pet owner know how much food has come out.
How much comes out when you click that knob?
When you hear a click, approximately a quarter cup has been dispensed, so you can gauge how much you are feeding per meal.
One of the things you mentioned is the price point, because it's not electronic and all that, all those gadgets. It's a little cheaper, easier to afford something like this, right? But when I say cheaper, I mean inexpensive. It's definitely well built.
Yes, and you can buy this for $44.99, which is, it's a good price for this product. It holds 10 pounds of food, and it delivers great portions for your pet.
You guys make some great quality products, and I got to say, the good thing about this is when you find it in the store, it's packaged just like this that we see right here, which is, it's not behind a box. You can actually try it in the store.
Correct. You can walk right up to the shelf and play with it, and turn the knob, see how it clicks, interact with the product so that you can know exactly what you're taking home.
Beautiful. It's the Petmate Portion Right food dispenser. It's the first one out of the box today. 1-866-405-8405 to pick up on this right now. Thanks, Christina.
Thank you for having me.
Pretty cool, huh?
I like it.
It's Hal and Dr. Debbie. We are up on the floor of SuperZoo, and with us is Marie Moody from Stella and Chewy's. Now, you've heard us talking about Stella and Chewy's all the time. That, of course, is Ladybug, the studio stunt dog's only food. That's what she eats exclusively. And now our cats are eating this. The cat food is doing very well, Marie.
It is. The cat food is, cats in general have been sort of underrepresented in the raw foods, and now we have something that really appeals just to them.
Well, when you had just the dog food, I got to be real honest with you, we'd put the dog food down and the cats would go over to it, so I'm really glad that you introduced the cat food. And of course, it's a raw diet, USDA inspected, no hormones, no fillers. It's really good food. What do you got new this year?
Well, What's new here is these single serve.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, they're single
serve. For cats?
Yeah, they're for cats, and they come in six flavors, and they reconstitute to the equivalent of a 3-ounce can.
Oh, wow. So the dry food's in there, you just open them up, and so this is good for people that travel. We have a lot of over-the-road truckers that travel that don't want to bring cans with them, so this is good.
You think a lot of truckers have cats?
Well, we actually
do. We have a fair amount. They have the whole litter set up, so yeah, this would be great. And you know, I don't know how many people go RVing, but I have a couple clients that go RVing with their cats, and this would be a great way to minimize the packing that you have to do.
Yeah, we've heard of iguanas, birds traveling with truckers. You'd be pretty amazed.
Really? How about bearded dragons?
Didn't we just hear, I think, a couple of weeks ago about a bearded dragon, I think?
Yes, we did. There's one in my son's classroom, and I can't wait to get one.
Really? So bearded dragon food on the way next?
You never know. You never know. It could be.
Okay, well, we want you to try this, Stella and Chewy's. In fact, we'll give you a sample to try. All you have to do is send us a self-addressed stamped envelope, the address over at the animalradio.com website. But we're also going to give away today one cat food and one dog food.
Yep, sounds great. A 12-ounce and a 16-ounce.
There you go. 1-866-405-8405. Marie, thank you so much for making our dog look so good.
She is gorgeous.
Isn't she? Have a great day.
Thank you.
Well, we're having a lot of fun. Alan Cook, who is from, we have some great sponsors of our news, Scoop Free and Frolly Cat. Thank you, by the way, for sponsoring these.
Very welcome. Happy to be on Animal Radio.
What do you got here today?
We have our three winners in a new product showcase at SuperZoo and our new toys for Christmas 2012.
And these are for the cats?
These are for cats. They're all on frolicat.com. We have the Frolly Cat Flick, which spits out a string for your cat to stalk and chase and grab.
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm. And it's, as always, like, the string's popping out. It's coming back in. It's like hide and seek for your cat.
Now, I got to say, Joey's actually trying to catch the string.
Yes, and I'm having a hard time. I'm doing it, too.
Well, it was hitting me in my side, and I actually wanted to go after it and kind of bat it myself, because just get it away.
So are a lot of humans entertained by this?
I think the humans can be equally as entertained as the cats. I mean, we design everything to be fun and functional, beautiful forms, and it's just a lot of fun watching your cats stalk, sit, chase, and jump onto toys.
They are beautiful toys. They have sort of the Apple, very simplistic. They look like they could be part of the Apple computer line.
They look real nice. They don't look cheap at all. I mean, they look like a nice little, almost like a game. You know, I remember it looked like Simon when I used to play. But no, I'm telling you, you can tell it's made really well just by looking at it. It's not going to fall apart when you take it home. It looks great.
Okay, so we got the Flick, and then we have the Pounce.
Then we have Pounce, and this is where we have the mouse on the track that moves back and forth. It moves clockwise, counterclockwise, stops, and changes direction. It'll hide under the domes. Your cat can stick its paws in the holes, on the holes, try to capture the mouse when it gets it. Got it. Then I'll kind of let it go and you can try again.
Very cool. And then over here?
This is Dart Duo.
This is Dart Duo, wow.
Update on Dart, which is one of our previous favorites.
Which I love.
Which now has not one, but two lasers, so two animals can play at the same time.
You know what I do is I sit in my room and I turn off the lights with one of these things. I'm really more entertained than anybody else.
This one entertains the people just as much as the cats.
You know, my dogs would actually love it, because I have a dog that goes crazy with laser light.
And, we'll find the cats can play with it, the dogs can play with it. You can adjust how fast it moves, slow, medium, or fast. It even has an adjustable timer where you can set it to turn off automatically.
This is a great idea for people whose cats have elimination problems, maybe they're scratching in their home. You find them something to do during the day.
You find them. What are we giving away today?
We're going to give away one of each. So we have the Flick, the Pounce, and the Dart Duo.
Okay, 1-866-405-8405 right now. What, Joey?
I said that's pretty cool. It sucks for us, though, but it's pretty cool, you know, because we're not allowed, so Hal tells us.
Animal Radio, we're coming to you live from SuperZoo, the Mandalay Bay Convention Center in Las Vegas. Just because we're broadcasting live doesn't mean that we're not answering your questions. Dr. Debbie getting her share of questions today, as well as Joey Volani, animal communicator Joey Turner, and dog trainer Alan Cable. Remember that we're giving away one of everything we're talking about today, as we do on our new pet product special. Write this number down, 1-866-405-8405. It's toll free. You'll need that today either to win one of the products that we're talking about. I see Ladybug's taking a break. What is that, mandated by the union?
Yes, of course. She gets 15 minutes every hour.
She's actually doing a lot of work. I noticed she's in the magazines here.
She's out working the crowd, too.
She's a Hollywood dog. Is she a little bit of a snob?
Just a little, but she has that right.
Take care of me.
I'm on fire. Put me out.
Look at me.
She's getting that break right now. We are with Tom Arnold from Pet Hub. Hey, Tom, how are you doing?
I'm fantastic, Hal and Judy. Thanks so much for having me on the show.
What is Pet Hub?
Well, we're the most comprehensive pet protection solution out there. We launched a site about a year ago where we have a free profile for your pet. Tag links to it. We do cool things like pulling GPS off the smartphone that accesses the tag.
Wow.
Send a map to the owner, letting them know exactly where the pet is. We even have emergency medical insurance to cover the animal if it's injured while missing. And we have an Amber Alert-like system where you can take that pet's profile on our website and broadcast it to all the local shelters if your animal goes missing.
Well, let's see. You have one of these tags in your hand?
Yeah, I actually have one of the collars by one of our partners.
Oh, it has one of those codes on it.
Exactly. It's called a QR code. So what happens is you can scan that with a smartphone or you can type in the web address. And we even have an 800 number for free that anybody can call that comes with their free profile.
Now, I'm not tech savvy. I have a hard time. Is this easy for me to do and put on my dog's profile?
Yes, absolutely. If you can do Facebook, you can do Pet Hub. I mean, it's essentially Facebook for dogs and cats.
And so when they call the number, what kind of information do you have that you're going to be able to give them?
It's essentially anything that you care to share when you set up the profile. What most people put on is a nice photo, close-up photo of your animal so that a shelter can help get them home faster or whoever finds your pet can help get them home faster. But not only that, I put my license number for my dog on there, his rabies tag. I even put his microchip number on there. Anything you can think of. The biggest one for me is I put his insurance information on there, so if he is taken into a vet, that awkward question that the vet asks the rescuing person of, are you
who's going to pay for this,
goes away because they see this animal's insured for $3,000 by our partner, Pet First Health.
$3,000 Pet First Health, that's a pretty good company.
They're a fantastic company. We've been partnering with them for a year, and they've been fantastic. Our users love them.
How do we get one of these?
Well, we're going to give a couple away for you guys, but for those who don't win, you can go to our website at pethub.com, and you can just sign up and order one of the tags, or you can go into, there's 1,000 retailers that just picked us up within the last couple of weeks, so we're now national, and the other thing that we just announced here at SuperZoo is we've gone international.
Oh, wow, congratulations.
Thank you so much. So we're localized for Dutch and German right now. We're also in the UK. We're in Australia and South Africa. So it's really starting to take off. It's crazy.
Now, is this a one-time fee, or is it a monthly thing or yearly thing I need to renew?
That's a great question, Judy. So what it is the free profile I was talking about has all your pet's data. Again, free, always free.
Oh, all very cool. Okay, what are we giving away today?
So we have a caller from our partner Dog IDs, and what we're able to do for you is you can put on your pet's name and either our 800 number or your own personal phone number, and it's already encoded with our QR code and the web address for your pet's profile.
1-866-405-8405. Remember, if you've won in the last 30 days or you've won anything on today's show, give someone else a chance. If you haven't, this is your chance to pick up on Pet Hub's new ID system.
Animal Radio is brought to you by
Help prevent pests on your pet with monthly topical flea or tick treatments. Advantage 2 for cats or dogs. Kills through contact, so fleas don't have to bite to die. Canine Advantix 2, which is for dogs only, repels and kills ticks, fleas, and mosquitoes. Repels biting flies and kills lice.
It's Animal Radio coming to you live from SuperZoo Las Vegas, the Mandalay Bay Convention Center, for our new pet products special. Joey Volani walking around. Boy, you see a lot of cool stuff.
This is great. This is unbelievable. And then the grooming on top of it. So I'm in my element. I watch the grooming. I go in. I check the show out. I find some neat stuff. I play with stuff. It's good.
Now, when you go over there to check out the grooming, do people get nervous?
I don't think so. I don't even think they pay attention to me from the ring. They're so involved in what's going on in the ring that they're not even paying attention to
me. You're not like, ooh, there's the judge from Groomer has it?
At some, sometimes, but I went over there before. I didn't think I intimidated anybody but myself, so.
Well, I got to tell you, I'm excited about these guys. KURGO has always been a topic of conversation with us here on Animal Radio because they make traveling with your dog or cat or whatever animal you have safe. And I love you guys for that. Jody Curtis is joining us. What do you got in your hands, Jody?
Well, I have a new product that we've just released. This is the first time that we've shown it. It's at this show, and it's called the Auto Grass. And basically what it is, it's a way to deter your dog from jumping into the front seat by using the console in between the two
seats. That's the problem that I have with Ladybug, the studio stunt dog, is she always jumps over and wants to get down between the console, and it's dangerous is what it is.
It is dangerous, and it's very distracting. So not only is the dog not safe being up there, but you're not safe.
Wow.
So what we've done is our designer, Kidder Spader, who is one of the owners of the company, he has designed a product that looks like grass. It stands right up. It's a hard plastic. And if you put a dog's paw or your fingertips on here, you'll note that hurts. It kind of hurts. But then if you put, but you think, well, now I can't use my console because it's got this hurty stuff, right?
You still can use it.
Because if you think about the idea of laying in a bed of nails, there's a distribution of your body weight that happens. And if you put your arm on here, Joey, put your right there.
My sleeve.
All right.
Oh, completely different.
Yeah, isn't that interesting?
It's actually comfortable.
It is. So it was created to be able to be used while deterring your dog, and they can't put their arm on there.
Are geniuses.
I know. It is such a great company that I work for, and so fun and innovative. We're constantly looking for new ways to present products that are going to keep you safe and keep your pets safe, but also have fun.
I see you can put your iPhone in there.
You can. We've made a spot for the iPhone, and it just straps right around the top of the console, so it's easy on and off as well. If you're not traveling with your pet, you can put it under the seat, and you can go and have your console the way you like it.
It's probably better, because I know my console, if I drive and you want to put your arm down, is a little too low. This kind of raises it up a little bit.
Right.
So, so I'm actually in a more comfortable spot there.
And
so
it won't hurt your back.
Exactly.
Right? Yeah.
And then my dog Miles won't be jumping into over the console. Well, I got four. So they want to constantly jump back and forth. So this is perfect for me.
Well, what you need is our seatbelt harness system.
Yeah.
To keep your dog safe. And, you know, with all the new legislation pending on distracted drivers and on keeping our pets safe.
Well, Jersey's
new
mandatory.
Jersey.
It's mandatory. You have to have your dog seatbelted in the car.
Either that or in a crate, but they need to be contained so that they're safe.
And what are we giving away today?
Today we're going to give away a $50 gift certificate that can be used on the KURGO.com website. And whatever lucky listener will be able to go on and get whatever they need.
Okay, 1-866-405-8405 right now. If you've won anything on today's show already or in the last 30 days, let someone else win. 1-866-405-8405. Jody, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having us.
You guys are awesome over at KURGO, KURGO.com to learn more. It's Animal Radio coming to you live from SuperZoo, the Mandalay Bay Convention Center. This is our new pet product special. Write down this number, 1-866-405-8405. That's the best way to get through and not only get your questions answered by our dream team, Animal Communicator Joy Turner, Dr. Debbie with your vet medical questions, Joey Volani with your grooming questions, and of course, Alan Cable answering all of your dog training questions. You seem intrigued.
This is a cool product.
Oh, what, the leash lock it?
Yeah, absolutely. I like this. It looks great, and it's, you know what, you never lose your leash anymore. Just leave it with the dog.
Well, let's talk to Leah about this. Leah Overton from the Leash Locket Company. What do you got there?
Well, this is our Leash Locket, and it's a brand new retractable leash. It's a full 6 feet, and it's super...
6 feet in that?
6 feet in this. Can you believe it? It's very small, compact, lightweight. And the cool thing is it comes with a magnet attachment that you snap onto your collar, and you can attach the leash to the collar. So your dog can run around at the dog park, and your leash is always there.
Thank you.
Yep.
Wow. And that won't fall off?
It won't fall off. It's really, really sturdy. It's a neodymium magnet, and then you just pull it off.
Neodymium.
Yes. Strongest magnet.
So when I'm in the dog park and they yell at me, is your dog leashed? I said, yeah, he's leashed, and I have it.
Exactly. I know. You can't get in trouble for that, right?
Alan, you get one of these for your dog.
I love that. That's really cool, and I like the pink color too. Are you nervous? Do microphones make you nervous? They make me nervous.
Oh, no, not yet, but maybe I am now.
Well, for Alan, whose dog is a little bit, won't wear pink, let's just put it that way. What other colors do you have?
We also have red, blue, and black, and it comes in two sizes, small and large. The small is dogs up to 55 pounds, large up to 90 pounds, which is a pull force of 200 pounds.
So holy moly.
Strong. Yep.
Wear pink.
Oh, he would if I asked him to really nicely. If you asked him to, Joey, I know he would wear pink.
I like pink.
Because you have a way with people and
dogs. I think that's sharp. Look at that. That's such a
look at that.
This is your color.
Let's go with black.
Yeah.
What's the website that we can learn more?
It's LeashLocket, which is LOCKET.com.
And can you get these in any stores yet?
Yes, you can. If you look on our website, we have a store locator, and we're getting bigger. We're international already, so all over the place. Yeah.
Very good. Is this your idea?
It's not. I wish it was. But it's actually my boss, Dave Marshall. It was his idea on a camping trip.
What was going on the camping trip? Why did he think it up?
They had an escapee dog who went to the next lot over, and he thought to himself, that dog always needs a leash on him. And he kind of thought about it and came back, researched it. There was nothing like it. So He's a smart guy.
What are we giving away today?
We are giving away one leash locket, one large leash locket. So that's for dogs up to 90 pounds. And if you enter, we'll get that sent over to you.
Okay, and we can pick our colors?
Yes.
Okay, 1-866-405-8405. Put that phone away, Joey. You can't win. 1-866-405-8405. If you've won anything today or within the last 30 days, let's let somebody else get in on this. It's for the leash locket, and you can learn the website's leashlocket.com.
Yes, it is. That's correct.
Thank you so much, Leah, for joining us today. You've been walking around all day, Alan.
I've seen everything. I've talked to all the people, and I've seen things that I've never seen before that I'm buying. Even if I didn't have a dog, I would buy these things just to keep them in my house and show them to people because they're so cool.
Pretty unique stuff.
Yeah, it's all kinds of cool stuff.
I think there's a lot of people that might have lost their jobs over the last few years, and they've thought of a great idea over happy hour, and now they're trying to pitch it, get the big stores to pick it up.
I wish, you know what? I haven't seen the idea I thought of that you said it was already invented.
What was that?
You walk in the house and your dog's feet get clean like a car wash. It's built into your house.
I gotta love that.
And it dries your dog's paws and then you bring them in. Yeah, well, like a machine.
Yes. I just let them run in the house. So.
It's Animal Radio coming to you live from SuperZoo in the Mandalay Bay Convention Center for our new pet product special. Stacy Cohn, you have scored. Look at your bag full of all kinds of goodies.
All kinds of free stuff. That's why I'm here, to get as much free stuff as possible. And there are so many cool things that I've seen.
Now, how are you getting the free stuff? I go up there, I talk to them, but I'm not like... My pockets are empty.
You have to ask. You have to ask. You have to say, I got this Tuffy thing. This from Tuffy, the mighty animal playthings. You know, they've got all kinds of products.
And the one with the open bar.
Right.
Oh, that's why you're there. I got it. Okay.
I just hung around for a few months. But I managed to score a Tuffy toy. Very cool. They're very expensive. And last time, my dog ate through one. He ate in it like 15 minutes. So I told her, I said, you know what? My dog ate through this last time. She goes, oh, I've got one here. It's got 7 layers of stitching. Your dog will not be able to eat it. Here, $10. I go, $10? I'm not paying $10.
As long as your dog doesn't eat it, and then, like, I'm going to have to cut it out of your dog, then we're going to have a problem.
Tell me about the pig's ears. I did get one of these pig's ears for my dogs, too.
Isn't your dog Jewish?
Yeah, thank you. Shh, don't tell my rabbi.
Oh, my God. So, yeah, pig's ears are okay. You know, you want
to
make sure.
Aren't they hard to digest, though? I've heard that.
Well, you want to make sure your dog chews them thoroughly. You want to have big pieces swallowed because that can cause an obstruction. And then just make sure it's made in the USA.
Okay, here's one other question I want to ask you. Some of these dogs have dyed hair. A lot of poodles with different hair. Is that bad for the dogs?
No, they use non-toxic natural products. And I'm sure Joey will attest. It's very safe. But you know what?
Joey, do you dye your dog's hair?
Yes, I do.
But you don't do all that crazy stuff that you see walking around here, do you? With three different colors?
No, I don't want to make my dog look like a bumblebee, if that's what you mean. No.
The dog that's a rainbow dog is probably gay, but don't put that on the air.
This is live. I don't know what you're
doing. Whoops. Anyway, it's probably a gay dog, but is that safe?
It's pride. It's showing. If you use the right product, it's safe. I mean, you can go in. The stuff that they use for kids, it's non-toxic. It's non-toxic for pets. You can use this. It's vegetable-based dyes. It's no problem.
Can you use Kool-Aid?
You can use Kool-Aid. Yeah.
Are you kidding? Is that a trick? Is that what the groomers do for the shows? They use Kool-Aid?
They used to. It's a little bit more elaborate now. They use stuff that's actually, since the Kool-Aid days, they've come out with products that actually are a little bit more intensified, that work. But yeah, you can use Kool-Aid. It's just like coloring an Easter egg. You know, you just color in hair.
Then I want to have some fruit punch if I'm going to smell my dog.
That's right. Add a little sugar and then there you go.
There you go.
Why did they lick there?
Okay. Well, there you go. I see you being the Tuffy.
I'm out of here.
Tuffy's booth in the open bar there.
Drinking for Stacy.
What, Alan Kidd?
That was beautiful. I love that.
Any booth that has an open bar, it's very hard to get people to come into your booth, and you try to do whatever dramatic that you can. They have an open bar, and they have DJs over there.
Yeah, it's hard to compete
with. I'm missing this, yeah.
It's a free bar. You should be over there.
Yeah, but Joey has a trapeze. When are you getting that out?
Yeah.
Well, after I have a few drinks at the open bar.
We have Michael Braun here with Oster. How are you doing, Michael?
Very good. How are you?
Very good. This is our new pet product special, 1-866-405-8405. We're giving away one of everything we're talking about today. What are you guys featuring this year?
We have the Shed Monster. It is a de-shedding tool for both cats and dogs. Gets all the loose hair out from under off your pet and get it off the floors.
Oh, hey, Joey, have you seen this?
I haven't seen this yet, and hold on. Oh, this looks cool.
It looks well made.
See, I need...
You know, I'm a good friend of your groomer, Christina Pulowski, and she didn't tell me about this, so I'm very upset. I should know about this. It looks great.
It does start from a professional grooming tool that's been out for about 10 years. We've been selling them, and this is now our consumer-friendly version.
You gotta love that. And where can we get it?
You can get it at Walmart, PetSmart, and Bed Bath Beyond.
Okay. Do we have one of those to give away today?
Absolutely.
Okay, 1-866-405-8405. What's the website where people can learn more?
www.shedmonster.com.
Thanks, Michael. I appreciate your time today from Oster. Do we have someone else over here, Dave?
I'm not sure. I got to talk to Stacy first.
I've got a private conversation going on. Sorry, this is live radio. What? We're coming to you live from SuperZoo at Mandalay Bay Convention Center. We're still taking your calls for your dream team, 1-866-405-8405. Is it a private conversation?
No, not at all.
Okay.
But I was looking at Joey going to get that drink over at the other place.
Oh, at Tuffy?
Yeah.
We should have a free bar next year.
That's right.
Yeah. You'll pay for that, right?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay, yeah. There you go.
Celebrating our connection with our pets. This is Animal Radio. Here are your hosts, Hal Abrams and Judy Francis.
And our dream team consists of Dr. Debbie answering your vet medical questions, dog trainer Alan Cable, dog father Joey Volani, animal communicator Joey Turner, and brand new to the team, Miss Wendy Diamond.
And we are coming to you live from Las Vegas and the Mandalay Bay Convention Center. Yes. Oh, Judy just got back from the bathroom. For some reason, everybody's going to the bathroom now. So we're drinking too much coffee here?
No, we're in Vegas. We're drinking too much liquor.
Oh, okay.
Too much alcohol.
That's what's happening.
Hey, we're working. We're working now.
Yeah.
We have your new pet products. Before you can buy them in the stores, we'll have them for you today. 1-866-405-8405. Write that number on your unk because that's what you're going to need to call when we tell you to call for the giveaways. We're giving away one of everything that we're talking about today, like we do every year. This portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by Veterans and One Step Wound and Skin Care products for hot spots, cuts, scratches, and even rashes. It's non-toxic and safe for your puppies and kittens. If you want more information, visit them at veterison.com. That's veterician.com. And in fact, let's go ahead and give away some. What do we have, Judy? We have five bottles.
We have five bottles of
five
this stuff.
Bottles.
It is great. I recommend everyone to call in. Something you should always have on
your
hand.
First aid
yes,
kit.
Definitely.
Okay, let's do that.
You know, I was using this stuff to clean ears, and it works great.
To clean what?
To clean ears. Dogs,
oh, ears.
Not my ears. Dog's ears. And it works. It works great. Actually, I had a dog that comes into the salon, and we've been using it, and it had real inflamed ears, and it actually took the redness right out. So it's good stuff.
It's good for hot spots and rashes too. And of course, we've used it on Ladybug several times.
Yeah, and also when she had surgery and she had her little wound stitches that needed to heal, it was great for it. It healed really quickly. And
good stuff.
The scar is real tiny.
I'm glad to have them as a sponsor, but I think those that know us at Animal Radio know that our sponsors, we use all their products and stand behind them 100%. Let's go to James, who has a call for Joey. Hey, James, where are you calling from?
Well, right now I'm in Lake Park, Georgia.
Lake Park, Georgia.
Yes, sir. I'm a truck driver, and I'm calling for a little bit of Joey's advice here on account of I have this little pug that loves to ride around with me, but sometimes we stay out on the road for very extended periods of time, and, you know, giving him a proper bath is not very feasible. So I'm wanting to know what I could do for him, you know, what products or what procedures Joey might recommend to keep him clean and, you know, healthy while he's out on the road with me.
So let me ask you a couple of questions here. What's your main objective? Is just to clean the dog? Is the dog getting stinky? Is it shedding?
Yeah, well, I brush him every day. But we're out sometimes for 2 months at a time, and it gets a bit oily and stuff, you know. And we're walking around in grass that, you know, I don't know what's in there.
There's a lot of products out there and wipes that you can go to the store and get a lot of some spray dry shampoos and you know a lot of things out there on the shelves that you can go out and buy. But if you want a real quick fix, and this works unbelievable, and it's good that you're brushing and combing the dog now because you're removing the dead coat. So if you're used to doing that, you're gonna go to the store and you're gonna buy yourself a 69-cent box of baking soda. Now baking soda, you're gonna going to sprinkle that in the coat. Now, it's going to do two things. It's going to, number one, remove the oil because it's going to absorb. So you're going to sprinkle it on. You're going to let it sit, I don't know, just a couple of minutes, and then you're going to brush it through. Not only is it going to absorb the dirt and the oil, it's going to also neutralize any odors, any smells, or anything like that. And it's going to, when you brush it, it's going to fall off the dog after it absorbs everything and fall to the ground. So the best thing to do is I wouldn't do this while you're in your truck. I would actually do this outside of the truck when you stop, sprinkle the dog with it, brush it through. It's going to be real safe. It's really good for the coat. The dog is going to smell good. And a really good thing and trick with dogs that have folds in their face, and some pugs do, some pugs don't, depending on, you know, how flat the face is. If you use that and you put that in the folds, it'll dry out any type of moisture that's in there, and the baking soda portion of itself will actually remove any facial odor. It works really good. It's a good thing. It's nice and cheap, and you know what? I think that you'll be really satisfied until you know. Now, listen, nothing's ever going to replace a good old soap and water bath, but this is something that you can stretch out with a short-haired dog. You could stretch it out quite some time and think, be real happy with it, too.
Well, that's fascinating, because that's one thing I was really worried about, was like the folds in his face. I mean, I get into a cutis every now and again, and I've been using like wet ones and stuff, but that's a very good tip. I'm
and,
really thankful.
You know what? And you can continue to use the wet ones, but the baking soda, you know, after you wipe it out with the wet ones, go in with the baking soda. And I'm telling you what, you're going to notice that there's no odor from the face. And if there's any irritation, any redness, 9 times out of 10, that's going to go away as well.
Mm. I use that on my mother-in-law. She has a real wrinkly face.
How?
She has kind of a stinky face, too. So, and I got that tip from you last week. I appreciate that. 1-866-405-8405 to connect with the Dream Team. We also welcome today Wendy Diamond as a new member of the Dream Team. And Wendy is the publisher of Animal Fair magazine. You've seen her on TV. You've heard her. She is well-known, and we are very excited to have her as part of the Dream Team. Welcome to the show.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you so much. Seriously, it's like such a privilege.
Now, hey, how did Hal get you? He had to bribe you. He had to, you know, trick you somehow. I mean, you know, we don't get talent like this.
So. Joey, you know better to ask that question.
On air.
Every week you're going to be telling us about a charity, something that's going on in the philanthropic world.
Well, yeah, exactly. I mean, there's so many amazing people out there making a difference in the world of animals. So I feel like really lucky to know a lot of these people and witness a lot of the work that they do. So I am so grateful to you guys for allowing me to promote a lot of these organizations out there that are helping the world of animals.
Wow, we are honored. What's up this week?
Did I have a blast? Joey, don't get jealous. I hung out with the New York Rangers.
Oh, wow.
No and their dogs. Way.
Not
yeah,
bad.
Can I tell you something?
Not
who
bad.
Knew? Who knew hockey players were so cute?
I was going to say, Joey, don't get jealous. What about me?
Joey was a hockey player, because you're a big guy, Joey, right?
Yeah, no, I was more of a football player, but that's okay. That's all right.
That's right.
You know what?
Right.
I'm still jealous.
Okay. Well, listen, let me tell you, the coach, who is such a sweetheart, did this charity in Riverside Park in New York, and Tortello is, you know, is seriously one of the best coaches in the hockey league, and he had a lot of the players out there, like Henrik, who's so cute, engaged, but so cute, and they all had their dogs, and it was a dog walk. It was a mile walk for their dogs. You know, Baby Hope could go up to 5 miles, but they did a mile walk. It was so much fun. Everyone got their photos with the hockey players. You could see more on our site. It's adorable. And I have to say, the Westchester Humane Society has just completely done a rehaul. They're opening up a new shelter, a new wing, and they have all new people leading that organization. And I just really hope everyone realizes, you know, like the Westchester Humane Society and humane societies all over the country, they are locally. They have nothing to do with the Humane Society of the United States. They're local, so that it's important for everyone mm-hmm. to support their local Humane Society. And that's what I loved about the New York Rangers. They came, they raised money for the Westchester Humane Society, and it was really a lot of fun. It was early for a Sunday, you guys. It was like 8 o'clock in the morning. After Saturday night, that's not easy, you know what I mean? But we got there. Baby Hope had bedhead, but it was really a lot of fun.
Now, you see, I didn't know there were local Humane Societies. I thought there was just one, you know, Humane Society. I didn't know there
Joey,
was local chapters.
Don't say that. I know you know better than that. No, absolutely. Yeah. People don't realize that the Humane Society and the SPCAs are actually by county. I'm not saying they don't help the local ones, but when you donate money to the ASPCA, that is not donating money to your local community shelter.
There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, Wendy Diamond, brand new to Animal Radio and the Dream Team. We are coming to you live from Las Vegas and SuperZoo this week.
Hi, I'm Dick Van Patten.
And I'm Jimmy Van Patten.
And we're here to talk to you about our new line of alpha grain-free dog and cat formulas. And we've been the leaders in grain-free nutrition with our LID formulas before grain-free became a trend.
Our new grain-free alpha formulas combine multiple high-quality proteins at balanced levels with unique fruits and vegetables for vitamins and antioxidants.
For more information on alpha and all of my dog and cat food formulas, visit naturalbalanceinc.com.
I lost 12 pounds.
I lost 7 pounds.
I lost 9 pounds.
I went from size 14 to size 8, and it was so easy.
These are real experiences of women over 40 who finally lost weight with Amberen. Once you're over 40, hormones and other body changes make losing weight practically impossible, especially if you're entering menopause. If you want to finally lose weight, including that stubborn belly fat, without additional exercise or difficult diets, there's no alternative to Amberen. Because Amberen is the only clinically proven solution for sustained weight loss in women over 40. Amberen reprograms your body to stop storing fat. It balances your hormones and improves metabolism. It's healthy, natural, and it works without additional exercise or tough diet plans. Call in the next 15 minutes to receive a complimentary risk-free trial with a 30-day supply free. Call 1-800-654-6449. That's 1-800-654-6449. 1-800-654-6449.
This is a referral service. Calls will be routed to an independent referral insurance agency.
Do you know the number one cause of bankruptcy? No, it's not losing your job or running up credit card debt. It's not even divorce. It's medical costs. If you and your family don't have health insurance, just one serious illness or accident could be financially devastating. But now there's good news, really good news. A health insurance hotline has been established to provide health insurance for all Americans, even uninsured Americans with pre-existing conditions. Now anyone can get health insurance even if you have a pre-existing medical condition. I repeat, now anyone can get health insurance coverage. Call now for a free no-obligation quote on affordable health plans available to you. Again, this is a free hotline for anyone, even if you have pre-existing conditions. Protect you and your family from sudden unexpected medical costs. Call the free health insurance hotline right now at 1-800-838-5562. That's 1-800-838-5562. Call 1-800-838-5562.
You're listening to Animal Radio. You can learn more at animalradio.com. Log on. Learn more.
Animal Radio is brought to you by Natural Balance Pet Food, the finest food you can buy for the health of your pet. No matter which line of Natural Balance Pet Food you choose, you know it will truly be the food for a lifetime. Visit www.naturalbalance.net to learn more.
Toll free 1-866-405-8405 to the Animal Radio Dream Team. Animal Communicator Joy Turner, Dog Father Joey Villani, Dog Trainer Alan Cable, Dr. Debbie, and brand new to the Dream Team, we welcome Wendy Diamond. And the phones are all ringing white hot. Seems like everybody has a call. We have a call for Joy on line 5, right? And on 4, Joey. And then are the rest over there? That's those all Dr. Debbie?
And some for
Holy
Alan.
Holy moly.
I know.
And we are live from Las Vegas this week for SuperZoo. This is the trade show where all the new pet products come out. We'll tell you about them before they're in your stores. And, in fact, we'll give them to you before you have a chance to buy them. So write that number down. This portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by Lubricin. Don't let your pets suffer with joint discomfort. End their discomfort with Lubricin. It tastes great, and animals love it. Visit them at www.lubricin.com. That's L-U-B-R-I-S-Y-N.com. And get 25% off your first order with the code Animal Radio. Animal Radio. Pretty simple. 25%, that's a pretty good discount, too. Susie, welcome to the show. How are you doing?
I'm wonderful. How are y'all today?
Y'all, where are you calling from, y'all?
Kentucky.
Kentucky. I just love that accent.
What bluegrass state.
What can we do for you there today?
I'm calling on behalf of my mother. She lives in Florida, and I'm going to visit next week, so I thought I could be proactive about this. She she has a female Siamese cat who's about a year old. She got her as a kitten as young as you're allowed to adopt one in the state of Florida. So I think she's 8 to 10 weeks when she got her. And got her from a reputable breeder. And great cat, very good personality. My mom lives alone. She's 85, so it's her companion. They get along great, have a great routine. But she has this tendency just out of the blue, no warning, no nothing, and she'll bite you. My mom did have her declawed, which I've read her the Riot Act about, but in Kentucky, and there was nothing I could do about that. And she had her declawed at a young age. But and it's not just my mother. It could be my sister, the neighbor lady, and the cat will just be sitting there very docile, just sitting, engaging in the conversation that the people have, watching them, and then reach out and bite them.
Okay. Now, do you know if there is contact? Are they petting the kitty before the bites happen?
The cat sleeps on mom's lap when mom reads. She gets great attention. My sister comes to check on my mom daily. Actually, I have two sisters down there, and they both check on her regularly, but my one goes daily. And she gives the cat treat. We call it cat candy. But
sure,
she gives her treats every time my sister comes, and the cat loves all the attention. We call her the diva. We had a family reunion in February, and all the siblings were there, and this cat just posed, and everyone took 20 pictures of it, and you could just see the cat eat it up. So she's a fiend for attention. She does have lots of toys. She has a cat tower that she climbs on. She has run of the house. And her and mom get along great. And she doesn't bite her every day. You know, it could be every third day or something, but you know, she's given her a couple of good bites in the forearm, you know, through blood.
Well,
and,
let me go through.
I'm a little concerned.
Okay, definitely. I mean, this is definitely not a behavior that anyone wants or expects from their kitty, but there's some basic causes for kitty aggression and for cats doing this. Now, when I asked if there was something preceding the bite, one of the more common things that can happen is cats can, if we're actually petting and stroking them, we can actually overstimulate them. And that can actually, it's something every cat's trigger is a little different. Some you can only pet the head and the neck area, and once you hit the torso,
I have a cat that it's where the tail meets the butt.
Yeah. So once you touch them along the back,
you don't touch that or you will get struck.
Right.
And I don't think it's a petting issue, because Margaret, the neighbor who got bit, she's not a cat lover, and she was just standing there talking to mom, and the cat happened to be on the counter, and Margaret was within striking distance.
Okay, so then let me go through the next most common causes of kitty biting.
Okay.
So if it's not something related to the physical contact, so that would be immediately preceding it, a pet-related bite is when we just pet them and we get to those touchy areas and then they bite.
Right.
That's a little different. So the other causes of biting in cats are actually attention-seeking. And you've mentioned this kitty is a diva. So a cat that is actually bored or understimulated, they will drive that attention. So they want to seek out human contact, even if that means you're going to yell and scream, because they're still getting
and the
that
cat
attention.
Knows she's doing wrong, because the minute she bites, she runs away.
No,
she's no dummy.
Hooey.
She's a
hooey.
Very intelligent girl.
Hooey.
Hooey.
Hooey. Okay, I got to stop you there. Susie, I got to stop you there, because that's a very common misconception. I know Alan's going to back me up on this, because dogs and cats don't understand that they're doing something wrong. They understand our reaction to that. They understand that we are becoming unhappy with them, but they really don't recognize that.
So
what they're doing, what we're doing when we're biting, is that we are grabbing your attention. So when the kitty is biting, she's getting the owner's attention, and that's getting you to get up off the couch, that's getting you to say, hey, what are you doing? And you look at her, you're making eye contact, you're making verbal contact, and that is in some ways a self, a rewarding behavior. So we want to avoid doing that. Now, a lot of these kitties, when I mentioned that they're bored, even if they have a lot of good stuff around, the indoor cats just naturally, they have a somewhat deficient environment. If they're outside, you know what? I'm not advocating that, but outside kitties have a lot to do. They're roaming, they're hunting, they're moving around, and they're burning calories and they're expending mental energy. When we keep kitties inside, they don't have that so much. So we need to look for ways to give them things to do. So what some of the big things I'd suggest for you is that we're going to increase the exercise and the playtime for this kitty. So even if she plays regularly, I want to schedule about 10 minutes, three times a day of playtime. And preferably things where we don't have close physical contact with human hands. So we want things like the cat dancer toys. We want to have laser tag type or laser toys. Things that we can keep the pet owner out of the equation. We don't want to have the human hand any be anything related to that playtime. And so for environmental enrichment, when I say that, you said cat towers, that's great, that's a wonderful thing, but there's other things. We want to make her work for her food. So one way we can do that is to add food dispensing toys into the mix. So if we do that, we want to limit the amount of food that she just has at the open bowl type thing. Put some of the food inside those treats. There's a lot of different companies that make these, and as the kitty plays with them, knocks them around, the food comes out, and it occupies mental and physical energy. So those are really big things that we really want to do.
That makes all good sense.
You know, Alan, a lot of the kitty stuff and dog stuff is quite similar, isn't it?
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense, you know, because the cat probably likes to chase things, and if the cat doesn't have an opportunity to go chase things, then it gets bored, and it could, to get a reaction, just reach out and clamp on to somebody, I'll bet.
And the big thing also is really we don't want to punish cats for biting. Negative reinforcement does nothing to help stop this. We want to look for the opportunities where that might happen. So as pet owners, we think, oh, nothing's setting the cat off. What we need to do is get really intuitive in watching kitty behavior, because they're usually given us some clues. We look for those ears going down and back. We're going to look for that quick swish of the tail, you know, maybe a growl. If we notice that, we want to get the kitty out of the situation or get yourself out of the situation. So social isolation sometimes can help, only to decrease the bite and also to decrease the arousal that the kitty has at that time. So,
But Dr. Debbie, the same behavior would not help, like if I just snuck up on my cat and bit him real quick and ran away? That would not help?
That wouldn't work.
No, and that's why, you know, people who think that by scruffing their cat or yelling at them, it's going to stop this, it actually can escalate that. And that can actually increase the chance that we're going to have a more aggressive bite in the future. So things like that really just don't fly with cats.
Thanks for your call, Susie. 1-866-405-8405 to connect with the Dream Team right now. That could be Dr. Debbie answering your vet medical questions, dog trainer Alan Cable, dog father Joey Volani, animal communicator Joey Turner, or Wendy Diamond. We're all here at your beck and call live from Las Vegas.
This is Glenn Close on Animal Radio, urging you to spay or neuter your pet.
The 4th annual Get Your Licks on Route 66 is a month-long pet adoption tour traveling down America's favorite highway the entire month of October, stopping at animal shelters along the way to hold adoptions. Thanks to sponsors Ford, Pet Plan Pet Insurance, Animal Radio, and Vital Friendly Magazine, this life-saving tour kicks off in Los Angeles on October 6th and ends in Chicago on November 2nd. Visit Get Your Licks on Route66.com to find out where the tour stops near you. You might just find your new forever friend.
Have you given your dog the gift of time? As many as half of all dogs have their active lives cut short by arthritis. Give your dog the gift of a long, healthy, active life. Give your dog Lubricin. Lubricin's oral joint supplement acts as a natural lubricant, ending your pet's discomfort. Lubricin has a formula for you, your pets, and your horses. Tastes great, and animals love it. Visit them at www.lubricin.com. That's LubriSyn.com.
I lost 12 pounds.
I lost 7 pounds.
I lost 9 pounds.
I went from size 14 to size 8, and it was so easy.
These are real experiences of women over 40 who finally lost weight with Amberen. Once you're over 40, hormones and other body changes make losing weight practically impossible, especially if you're entering menopause. If you want to finally lose weight, including that stubborn belly fat, without additional exercise or difficult diets, there's no alternative to Amberen. because Amberen is the only clinically proven solution for sustained weight loss in women over 40. Amberen reprograms your body to stop storing fat. It balances your hormones and improves metabolism. It's healthy, natural, and it works without additional exercise or tough diet plans. Call in the next 15 minutes to receive a complimentary risk-free trial with a 30-day supply free. Call 1-800-654-6449. That's 1-800-654-6449. 1-800-654-6449.
This is an Animal Radio News Update brought to you by Frolic Hat, the award-winning automatic pet toys that provide hours of fun for you and your pets.
I'm Stacey Cohen for Animal Radio. Dog bites are one of the risks that kids face by playing outdoors, and Dr. Ann Breyer, who's a pediatrician in emergency medicine at the University of Rochester Medical Center in New York, has a few suggestions to help you out to keep your kids away from those dog bites. Remain calm and don't aggravate a dog. Those are key elements in preventing them. Dogs bite when they feel anxious or threatened. Never leave an infant or a young child alone with the dog, and keep kids away from dogs that are eating or sleeping. Be careful when you visit older relatives with dogs, because these dogs aren't used to having kids around. They could be jealous of the attention they receive. And remember, all breeds of dogs can bite. A dog's upbringing plays a much larger role in its tendency to bite than its breed. About 4.5 million people are bitten by dogs each year in the U.S., according to the U.S. Center for Disease Control and Prevention. Kids most likely to get a bite, they're between the ages of 5 and 9 years old. Have you noticed that your dog or cat is increasingly forgetful? They get lost in the corner of a room, or they seem like they forget where the litter box or dog door is? Well, if a visit to the vet rules out organic reasons like an ulcer or cancer for the unusual behavior, your pet may be diagnosed with cognitive dysfunction syndrome, what in humans is called senility or Alzheimer's. If CDS is indeed diagnosed, easy environmental changes can help bring about some improvement. What they suggest is maintain a routine so your pet eats or goes for walks at the same time every day. Feed a diet that contains high levels of antioxidants, which have been demonstrated to enhance brain health, and keep your pet's brain sharp. Play with them. Do some extensive training. Most important, be aware of changes in behavior. They can signal the onset of CDS. The earlier you intervene, the more chance you have of staving off the signs. Well, this is a rhetorical question, since the only thing that really matters is premium pet food worth the extra money to you? Because it's so important to so many pet owners, pet food's a $20 billion a year business. So here's what we found out. Is it worth the extra money? Well, there have been precious few long-term independent studies on pet food. And pet food you choose should be nutritionally balanced. Vets say it should be labeled with a statement of nutritional adequacy, showing it meets the Association of American Feed Control's official guidelines. Just as with people food, the first five ingredients listed on the label will tell you lots about the nutritional value. Premium pet food doesn't always contain more balanced nutrition, nor is it immune to recalls or contamination. Millions of people feel very strongly about their pets. They believe if they eat natural food, their pet should too. And Dr. Tony Buffington, a veterinary nutrition professor at Ohio State University, makes it clear that pet owners shouldn't feel guilty about buying less expensive but nutritionally balanced brands. I'm Stacey Cohen, so get rid of that guilt. Get more animal breaking news at animalradio.com.
This has been an Animal Radio News Update brought to you by Frolic Hat, the award-winning automatic pet toys that exercise and entertain your pets. Learn more at frolichat.com.
Cats need to stimulate their curiosity, and Frolic Hat toys automatically entertain and exercise your pet. Turn on Frolic Hat Bolt or Frolic Hat Dart and watch your cat chase after randomly generated laser patterns. Or program Frolic Hat Twitch to turn on automatically so your cat can play while you are away. Frolic Hat's award-winning designs fit into your modern home and are fun for you and your pet. Buy them at your favorite store or learn more at frolichat.com.
What dog food is specifically designed to reduce the risk of cancer, settle digestive upsets, reduce scratching and shedding? Canine caviar. What dog food reduces red tear stains and hot spots? Canine caviar. What dog food has probiotics that reduce the chance of soft stools and have a higher calorie count for better nutrient absorption? Canine caviar. So what are you feeding your dog? If you didn't answer Canine Caviar, visit caninecaviar.com today and get your pet started on a longer, healthier life.
This is a referral service. Calls will be routed to an independent referral insurance agency.
Do you know the number one cause of bankruptcy? No, it's not losing your job or running up credit card debt. It's not even divorce. It's medical costs. If you and your family don't have health insurance, just one serious illness or accident could be financially devastating. But now there's good news, really good news. A health insurance hotline has been established to provide health insurance for all Americans, even uninsured Americans with pre-existing conditions. Now anyone can get health insurance even if you have a pre-existing medical condition. I repeat, now anyone can get health insurance coverage. Call now for a free no-obligation quote on affordable health plans available to you. Again, this is a free hotline for anyone, even if you have pre-existing conditions. Protect you and your family from sudden unexpected medical costs. Call the free health insurance hotline right now at 1-800-838-5562. That's 1-800-838-5562. Call 1-800-838-5562.
It's Animal Radio. We are back out on the floor at SuperZoo at Mandalay Bay Resorts. You are all giddy, are you not?
I am. We're having so much fun meeting people, checking out their products, and everyone's just really upbeat today.
Now, of course, Natural Balance has been a big old sponsor of Animal Radio for a long time. Steve Garvey, we have you on the air all the time, commercial running. You're out here today pitching, should I say?
Right. The first baseman pitching. This is
you gotta enjoy
very unique today.
Now, yeah. Are you getting writer's cramp? I see you're signing baseballs.
Oh, gosh. Well, I was here yesterday, and it's over the last 4 or 5 years, I've had a chance to come to the show. It's been a great show for Natural Balance. We've been involved for several years now on a personal basis as a spokesman, but also heavily involved in our sports marketing, not only domestically but around the world. But it's days like today, where you're actually on the floor here, people are getting a chance to come up. We have baseballs and bats and a chance to talk to not only our customers but future customers and people in the industry. So it's really a fun day, a fun show, and very productive.
Well, let's talk a little bit about the food. Now, do you have dogs at home?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, we've had several dogs over the years. And now we have Spartacus. He's just a little 140-pound Rottweiler that my wife rescued about, I'd say 4 months ago. So he's our latest and biggest of the litter, so to speak. But we also have 7 kids. You know, of course, all but 2 of them are gone. Older daughters around the country, New York, Washington, L.A. A daughter had just gone to the University of Arizona. Son Ryan, who's 19, just signed with the Rockies. And,
Wow.
And a leprechaun, Sean Fitzpatrick, who's 13. He's the only one.
Following after you.
On a regular basis, yeah. So we're a very, very busy household, but Spartacus has taken the place of a few of the humans now.
Well, now, Spartacus, you say your wife brought him home, and will you all go for that?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, we've had different dogs over the past. We've had couple expire on us and pass away, and of course everybody's always sad about that, so we're constantly renewing our commitment to the dog world and
sure.
New members of the family, you know, so and Natural Balance has been an integral part. So once we started this relationship, and of course having Tillman as I've been the warm-up act for Tillman. People laugh at that. You know?
Tillman, of course,
and
the
Patton and I do a little song and dance. And then
do you?
It's Tillman. Yeah. But, you know, we have a lot of fun with it. And, of course, Natural Balance is on the cutting edge of marketing for the industry. And we do so many unique things. And from, you know, Rose Parade floats to stadium sponsorships to Bark in the Parks. We just had one at Dodger Stadium where we had about 700 dogs and 4,000 people take over the whole right field pavilion. We had a pup rally about an hour and a half before the game.
Oh, wow.
We do a parade around the warning track, which is really phenomenal. A great memory for people to be able to be actually on the floor of the stadium looking up. Everybody always looks down, wonder what's it like, and they get a chance to do it. So that's what we do. Pretty unique things in the world of pet food marketing. But it's things like this. And, you know, we've become quite synonymous around the country with Major League Baseball as really the one company that does a significant amount of advertising
sure.
with Major League Baseball. So we're having fun with it.
You guys are always doing good stuff. And, you know, besides the marketing, the advertising, it's just some pretty good darn food, too, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Steve, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you. Thanks.
Steve Garvey on Animal Radio. Isn't she?
Yes,
beautiful?
Absolutely.
Okay. You're going to sign a baseball for me?
Absolutely. I've got Jose Canseco with us over here
today.
Yeah,
let's go. Let's go track him
we
down.
We have a significant female line here today.
Yes, yeah. I bet you do. We'll give away some Natural Balance right now at 1-866-405-8405. I'm going to sneak on over here to Jose and see if we can say hello to him. He's signing baseballs right now. Hey, Joey, how are you doing?
I'm doing great.
Joey Herrick, of course, from Natural Balance, the top dog over there. You're taking care of things. You're always, I love the New Year's Day parades.
Well, the parades have been great. This year, it's really special. It's a...
You're going to tell us. I thought it was a secret.
Nope. Our float is actually going to be honoring military working dogs.
Very good.
And we're involved with the first ever monument signed by Congress
wow.
and President Obama to honor the military working dog.
Wow.
So that's what our float's going to be, a replica of in flowers, and it's
wow.
going to be a great event this year.
You guys always outdo yourselves, always Guinness World Book Records, too.
Yeah,
for what
this
doing.
Is very special this year because of the military.
Yes, it is, and very important. Hey, Jose, can I grab you for a second? I just scared him. Jose Canseco joining us. How you doing today?
Great. I'm here, Natural Balance, having a great time.
Oh, look
at this pretty blonde right here.
Oh, my God, you're so tall.
I know. How come everybody says that?
I need my heels. You are just so tall.
I was so much taller when I was younger. I was like that. Now I got old and shrunk.
You're blushing.
I am. I am so sorry.
Are those your natural green eyes?
They are.
I'm married.
Damn it.
Forget it. Next. Are they really your natural green eyes? Let me see that.
You know, look at that.
Yeah, that's hot. You should marry. Darn it. All right, whatever.
I'll tell him he's a very lucky guy, yeah.
Yeah, your husband's very lucky. Damn you.
No. So are you getting writer's cramp from all these baseball signings here? You do that all the time anyway.
Yeah, right? I'm kind of used to it. I have a lot of stamina, like doing autograph stuff like that. So we've been nonstop for like an hour and a half, and hopefully it continues. A lot of people come over here, Natural Balance. Have fun.
Do you have dogs at home?
I have a Great Dane Weimaraner mix. I should have brought him. His name is Bruce. He's 130 pounds. He's
wow.
the most gorgeous dog. Not because he's my dog. He's the most gorgeous dog ever. I should have brought him.
130 pounds. Does he sleep in bed with you?
He does. He actually is very sprawled. He has a big air mattress beside my bed.
But he won't.
But he jumps on my bed all the time.
Yeah, that's how that works.
And then I kick the girl out.
Yeah.
Then I'm with. So he gets pissed off.
Does he eat Natural Balance?
Yes, he does.
Good food, huh?
Very good for the dog. So he's real healthy. He's... God, I should have brought him.
You really should have brought him.
He's very...
That's Ladybug, the studio stunt dog.
Oh,
I can't be an appetizer.
This close to bringing him. I was going to bring him in my car because I drove from L.A. I should have brought him.
What's his name?
Bruce.
You
would have loved. My daughter named him Bruce. For Bruce Almighty.
Bruce
in that movie, you know.
The movie. Wow, okay. Well, we'll let you get back to signing some baseballs here. And I appreciate you talking to us today.
Okay, thanks. Bye, green eyes.
Take care. Jose Canseco, Steve Garvey, Joey Herrick, all at Natural Balance, good food. Let's go ahead and give away another bag, 1-866-405-8405 right now.
You're a vet. You're beautiful. You're smart.
And she's making Jose Canseco, you know,
busy. Oh, yeah, I heard he came on to you.
Yeah, he signed his balls for me.
His baseballs.
His baseball. And a bat. He had a bat, yeah. too.
What did he say?
No, he didn't pull the bat out.
He didn't pull that out.
He pulled the bat out, just the balls.
No, just the balls,
He was
yeah.
embarrassed by the bat. He didn't want to pull that out.
He didn't offer.
They're not big bats. They're only about... How big are those bats, Judy?
Oh, they're only about...
Not that your average bat size.
18 inches, yeah.
We are coming to you live from SuperZoo in Las Vegas, the Mandalay Bay Convention Center, the new pet product special. We're giving away one of everything we're talking about today. Write this number down, 1-866-405-8405. And I got to say, Dr. Debbie is still a little bit giddy from meeting Jose Canseco.
Yeah, I'm still blushing. Just a very, very impressive man. He kept standing up taller and taller, and he just kept growing.
He did, and he was checking your eyes out. Like, I didn't believe that was your color, your very green. Do you wear contacts?
You know, I do, but this is
really?
Las Vegas. You know, so not everything's real in Las Vegas, right?
No, very few things are real. But he did check to see if you had a ring on your finger.
He did, yes, and I'm taken, but, you know.
Never hurts to...
maybe I could be convinced, though.
Joey, you missed that. I'm sorry. Have you had a chance to meet Steve Garvey and Jose yet?
No, I haven't yet. I've been running around checking out all new products and talking to people, and I'm not as giddy about Jose as Dr. Deb.
He showed some respect. He saw the ring, and he recognized I was taken.
But he signed his balls.
And not as bad. You tell me, that's a pretty small bat, right?
Yeah, that is a pretty small bat.
For Jose Canseco, you would think.
I guess you don't hit many home runs with this bat.
No, you don't.
Ooh.
It's just an animal show. Just in case.
Damn right it is.
Hi, this is Elaine Boozler on Animal Radio. Stay new to your pets and some of your exes.
It's Animal Radio, your lucky dog, coming to you live from the floor of SuperZoo at Mandalay Bay Convention Center in Las Vegas, hometown for Dr. Debbie.
It's my stomping grounds here.
You were checking out Ladybug's teeth a few minutes ago. As you do, you flip everybody's gums for some reason.
You've got to lift the lip and see what's lying beneath. So you got a little work to do, Hal.
I know, we're working on that. But I'll tell you, she just tried one of these gumbones, and she... She's pretty finicky, and she really liked it. And we have with us from Gumbo, David Peng. Hey, David, how are you doing?
How are you doing, guys? Good.
You're from Hawaii?
We're from Hawaii. I know, don't I look like the typical Hawaiian guy? I mean, if you look at me in a dictionary, it's just a picture of me for Hawaiian.
DeBro. DeKine.
Bra.
Bra, sorry. Bra. I lived on Kauai, and I was the Halley boy because I said stuff like that. But
okay. Yes, sir. We'll let you slide today.
Let me slide. So tell us about Gumbo.
Well,
Gumbone.
Gumbone, right? It's a dental tree. It's all natural, fully digestible dental tree that I developed. It took me about 2 years to make it.
Oh, wow.
And what it is, you know, we've all heard the other stories about some of the other dental trees out there and the problems that they've had. So when we were developing ours, we made special cautions to make sure that product is fully digestible. So should your dog take a big chunk of it, it actually breaks down in their gut and you don't have any digestion problems. But we also want to address the gulping issue that dogs naturally have as the way they eat.
They like to eat fast.
They like to eat, and then, you know, basically they take a big old gulp and they swallow it down. If it fits down their throat, it's
That's
gone. So we actually have some technology. We have a patent on some of the products on it. We have these nubs on it that actually breaks off. It actually slows down your dog's chewing because the dogs have an easier time grabbing hold of the product to take a bite out of it versus trying to grab a big piece of the treat to bite it. They can actually take a smaller bite and then break it down. And the nubs actually break off as the dogs begin chewing. That actually creates sensitivity, makes it creates a sensation on the inside of their mouth that forces them to want to play with it a little bit more. And it actually slows down. And we've worked with 4 vets on Hawaii to get this thing, you know, the way it is today.
And it's cleaning their teeth, too.
It cleans your teeth. And we know, I mean, Dr. Deb can tell you that, you know, 75 to 80% of all dogs have periodontal disease by the time they're 3 years old because most people don't brush their teeth. So we want to make something that actually works and it's affordable, obviously, that people can use it every single day to help them, you know. And we still recommend people go and see your vet, get your prophy done, you know, when you're supposed to. But this is something that can help you in between those segments.
Preventative, too. If you start early when they're young.
Early, there you go. And, you know, because they're fully digestible, 6-week-old puppies can have them.
Okay, where can we get them?
We have, actually, if you're in Hawaii, pretty much every store in Hawaii. But we just launched.
Good reason to go to Hawaii.
Hey, you know what? We need more tourists there. Come on, bring your money over.
Hey, I'll be there soon.
Yeah, I see, Dr. Deb. But you know, in the United States, right now, you can get it at Digit.
Got a website?
We got a website at gumbone.com. We have the list of retailers on there. You can see us on Facebook and on Twitter. You can purchase the product on Digit.com. D-I-G, dig it, I-T, digit.com. And, you know, hopefully you see it in a lot of stores. We had a lot of great feedback on the last 2 days. We have a lot of orders the last 2 days. So, you know, you'll be starting seeing it in a lot of stores.
What does it taste like? That ladybug just goes crazy.
It's just chicken.
Chicken.
Like, we actually use real chicken.
And it's got a gum-like, a gummy bear consistency. So if you feel it, it's kind of got some give.
And that's there for specific reasons. So your dogs actually chew it, and it doesn't. If it's so hard, the dog basically, once your dog breaks the initial surface, the product just cracks in half, and that's when they swallow it. But ours being, it's gummable. The dog's teeth actually goes through the whole thing, and in that process helps clean their teeth and slows down their gulping.
We should probably give this to Uncle Louie, who likes chicken, and frankly, I don't think he brushes his teeth.
No, I wouldn't do that.
It can't hurt.
Oh.
It can't hurt.
Okay, very good, and we're going to give some away right now, a bunch of samples at 1-866-405-8405. If you've already won something today, give someone else a chance, or within the last 30 days, 1-866-405-8405 to pick up on the gumbo. David, thanks so much for dropping by.
Thanks, Dr. Deb.
You're listening to Animal Radio.
It's Animal Radio coming to you live from SuperZoo in the Mandalay Bay Convention Center for our new pet product special. Write this number down, 1-866-405-8405. We're giving away one of everything we're talking about today, and I'm telling you, there's a lot of great stuff out there on the floor. You're finding some good stuff, aren't you, Joey?
I'm like a kid in a candy shop.
You are. I noticed this.
I am going around. I'm getting stuff, getting all new ideas. This is great.
Are you telling them that it's your birthday? They're giving you stuff?
No, you know what? That's a good... I didn't even think of that. That's true. And it is. So it's not like I'm lying.
Yeah. At our big dinner last night, you got a lap dance. How'd you like that?
Yeah. It was a nice... She had a nice hairy chest, a nice big tattoo across her big belly.
Can we post those pictures over at the website?
Yeah, I guess. Why not? It's already done. It's going to come out anyway, so let it fly.
There you go. Joey Villani, ladies and gentlemen. 1-866-405-8405. Write that number down. You will need it during the show. If you have a question for any one of our dream team, we're still taking your calls for Dr. Debbie, Joey Villani, animal communicator Joey Turner, or Alan Cable. With me is Dudley Fetzer, and he is from Tagg. Now, we've talked about Tagg before. Last year with the pet tracker, it's a GPS device to help you find your dog. And there's a lot of them out there, but they've done something that's, I think, absolutely incredible. You're not going to find it on any other device. like this anymore. Explain what the new Tagg is all about.
Okay, so thanks a lot for inviting us here, Hal. And we're really excited to talk to you at SuperZoo about this new functionality within Tagg. Tagg, the pet tracker, as you know, is the best tool out there for finding and recovering your dog. The dog can actually let you know if he's escaped and where to find him on a map. It's great, but we're going to go one step further with that. This fall, we're launching new functionality. We call it activity tracking. Do you ever wonder what your pet does when you're at work? Does he get enough exercise?
No, my pet's in front of the TV, I'm sure.
Exactly. So now you can actually see what he's doing every minute of the day. How much energy is it exerting so that you know that am I going to watch Monday Night Football or should maybe I take Sam out for a little walk?
Gotcha.
So the way we look at it, this is a fun new way to communicate with your dog. It's really like giving him a cell phone, saying, hey, I want you to call me if you ever get lost and I'll come pick you up. And by the way, I want to know what you're doing all day long.
Okay, now how does it know what your dog is doing?
Well, part of the system is a motion detector, and we can track movement and the activity level of the pet throughout the day, every minute. And then you get we equate the amount of movement to a level of activity, whether it's resting, which is, dogs are really good at, they do a lot of, 16 to 18 hours a day, or highly active, or in a couple of levels in between, medium active. And if you go for a walk, it's kind of a highly active, it's engaged activity. So we can track all those, and we assign points, we call them Tagg points, to each amount of time in each activity level. So a dog like my Sam, who is extremely low activity or lazy, perfectly good shape, but just a low activity dog, he averages about 250 Tagg points a day. So I know if he's only getting about 230 or 40, I need to get him a little exercise because his average is 250.
Oh, so it can tell you when you should take your dog out for more walks.
Exactly. And something your dog would probably want to tell you if he had a way to communicate that to you.
And is this all web-based? I can see the results online?
Yes, it's web-based, but in addition to web-based, you can get the information on a smartphone.
Oh, cool.
We have iPhone apps and Android apps. We also have a mobile web browser. All of the information available online is also available on your mobile device.
Where can we get one of these?
Well, right now, you can learn more information and buy right at tagg.com. We're also available at Amazon. We're available at all Apple stores. We're available at Target stores. And for this holiday, we're going to be available at Sam's Clubs, Best Buy, and even a Staples holiday selection. We also are various select veterinarian clinics and hospitals, as well as pet boutiques.
This is cool for your lazy dogs, Joey.
Well, hold on. I just want to ask a quick question. So it's a GPS device, correct?
That's correct.
So I'm out walking the dog, and I tell my wife that I'm walking the dog, and I go somewhere else. I'm caught, huh?
Only if she wants to catch you. But you don't have to give her the password.
She may not want to catch you is what I believe he's saying.
So let me give you an idea what you might do. The device that I'm holding right here has, you obviously can't see it on the radio, but has a big button in the middle. Push this before you go for a walk, and it won't tell anybody you're on the walk.
Oh, okay. See, I love it now.
Yeah. Now, if you happen to lose your dog on that walk, you can locate him.
Designed by a man.
Very good. I love the device. Now, it works with GPS, also with cell phone towers.
Yeah, and so actually, it is very much like a cell phone. This is that first cell phone you give your teenager, and you say, you don't say, hey, go get on Facebook and text all your friends. You say, you only use this in an emergency. Call me if you need help or need picked up. That's when you use it. That's what this is. So it is a cell phone, but the pet isn't smart enough, unfortunately, to be able to dial himself and let you know when he's in trouble. So it's a smart cell phone that will know when to make the call. So it looks, first off, it says, hey, am I at home? If I'm at home, I'm not going to wake up. I'm not even going to use my battery. But if I'm away from home, I start to check out the GPS satellites. And if I notice from the satellites that I'm not where I'm supposed to be, I'm going to send a text or an email to my owner and say, hey, I'm no longer at home. Would you like to track me?
Sure.
And it also uses the cell networks. In case it doesn't get a good enough satellite signal, it starts to use the cell network to get a better location.
Good.
So we can do indoor location. We can do under the tree, under the car. Where's the dog hiding?
Can you set perimeters on it?
Exactly what you do. You put in an address. It's as simple as that, and it'll draw a circle around that address. And that circle is our Tagg zone. And that is what the device looks for. If somebody violates that Tagg zone, goes on an unauthorized mission, that's when you get a message. But if you go on an authorized mission, like you go to the grocery store or the dog goes for a walk, you might want to push the trip button.
Sure.
And that way you won't be alerted.
That's cool. It looks really cool, too.
It's so small. I can't believe that you get all that information in such a small device.
We did a lot of research, and it was funny. The number one and number two attribute that people wanted to see in this type of product, you would think, is to find your dog. Number one and number two was lightweight, comfortable, and comfortable and stylish. They cared about what it looked like on their dog, so we tried to make it look good.
That fits into a charger, so you don't have to keep replacing batteries?
Right. It's a rechargeable battery. They're built in. They're also sealed in there so that the dog can swim, can get out in the rain and the snow, be bathed without having to take it off.
It is beautiful. You guys have thought of everything, and it only gets better with the new interface that you've introduced with it. Is this what we're giving away today?
This is exactly what we're giving away. We'll give away a Tagg unit with 1 year of service included.
Now, how much do these units cost? They're pretty inexpensive.
Right. At retail, they're $99, $99.95. So basically, you're getting a cell phone that your dog can use for $99.
Let's give one away. 1-866-405-8405 right now. What's the website?
Tagg.com. T-A-G-G.com.
Two G's. Two G's on that. Dudley, thanks so much for joining us today. You guys are awesome.
Thank you. Thanks a lot for inviting us, guys.
Wow, I can't believe we fit all that into 2 hours.
I know, there's a lot going on today.
Remember to join us over at Facebook at Animal Radio, or tweet us at Animal Radio, or download the Animal Radio app. You can ask your questions all week long for iPhone or for your smartphone Android. It's all there. And we'll see you next week back from our studios in Central California. Have a great week. Thanks for joining us.
Bye-bye.
This is Animal Radio Network.